Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to a new video. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about a very important topic from identity and access management in Google Cloud, and it's called service account. So if you're new to Google Cloud or planning for any Google Cloud certification, then understanding of this topic is very important. Please stay till end of this video because I'm going to show you how to create the service account, and there will be a small use case to use the service account to perform some activity inside Google Cloud platform. So without wasting any more time, let's jump into our Google Cloud console. So let's first understand what is a service account. A service account is a special kind of account which is linked to an application. It's not linked to a human being. Normally, when an account is getting created, it's normally linked to a human being, and that account tells what that human being can do or what type of action that human being can perform. But service account is not linked to a human being, it's linked to an application. And with this service account, that particular application is going to interact with other GCP services. So what service account is basically doing, it's actually linked to a GCP application, and then the service account is used to authenticate and authorize these GCP services to communicate with other GCP services. So as you can see in the screen, on the left side, I have a virtual machine. On the right side, I have a Google Cloud storage. And what I want to do is basically from virtual machine, I want to execute some command which will basically go and check in what is there inside Google Cloud storage. For example, what are the files there inside Google Cloud storage bucket? Or if I have a file, can I copy that file from my virtual machine and put it inside my Google Cloud storage bucket? So that type of communication can be done by service account. The service account is here inside this virtual machine. The service account is linked to this application called virtual machine, which is running in Google Cloud platform. And the service account is authorizing and authenticating virtual machine to communicate with Google Cloud storage and then perform all sorts of operation. So I hope the basic understanding of a service account is clear. So with that, let's understand what are the different types of service account we have. We have basically three types of service account. One is a user managed service account. Basically, the service account that you create. So if you create a service account, it means you need to manage the service account. So in a couple of minutes, I'm going to show you a demo where I'll be creating my own service account, and that's called the user managed service account. Default service account. So default service account is basically a service account which is created by default by Google every time you enable a service. So every time you go and enable a service inside Google Cloud, sometimes create a service account that is called the default service account. But Google Cloud is not going to manage the service account. It's you who needs to manage the service account. And finally, the service agent. Service agents are basically the agents or service account which are managed and created both by the Google Cloud. Basically, three types of service account: user managed, default, and service agent. So these are the things that you need to know if you're going for a certification. Okay, with that, let's go for a demo. So the first thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to create a service account. So for that, I am inside my Google Cloud console. From here, I'm going to IAM and going to IAM and admin. And from here, I'll go to the service account. Here, I can click on this create service account. And let's give a name as my new test service account. This is coming automatically. Service account name always comes in a format of email address. So whatever you type, that will come here, followed by whatever your project name and some numbers. So this is the email address. This is the email address associated with the service account. So let's create and continue. I'm not choosing any role right now. Continue and done. So as you can see, this is a new service account, my new test service account being created. Now, I have to create a virtual machine using this service account. For that, let's go back here and go to Compute Engine and click on Create Instance. I'm not changing anything. I'm keeping the name same as it is. The important thing is that identity and API access, here you have a option called service account. Here, what you can choose, as you can see here, Compute Engine default service account. This is a service account. You remember I was telling there are three types of service account, right? One is a default service account is being created when we enable some service. So This is a default service account. The moment we enable the compute engine, Google automatically created a service account that is called the compute engine default service account. But here for this demo, I'm not going to use the default one. I'm going to use the one that I have created just now. So the one that I've created is my new test service account. So I'm going to use that, keep everything same as it is, and click on create. So what it's going to do is going to create the virtual machine. So let's wait for a few minutes and let the virtual machine be created. So I'll be back once the virtual machine is ready. Okay, seems like my virtual machine is ready. So let me activate the cloud shell. Okay, so cloud shell is here. First, I am going to authorize. Sorry, it should be G cloud. Okay, seems like I have authenticated myself. And now the first thing that I'm going to do, I'm going to describe this virtual machine and see whether the service account is really linked to this virtual machine or not. So for that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to initiate a command, which is called gcloud compute instances describe, and then the instance name, which is basically this one. Okay. It's going to US East 1, what is no. Open that, I'll select no, because it's telling whether the zone is US East 1, but as you can see, my zone is US Central 1, so I'm going to type no. Okay, let's have command ran, and now here the important thing is that under the service account, you can see this is a new service account that I've created. So it means my virtual machine is successfully linked with the service account that I want to use. Now with that, there are multiple scopes. You remember when you create the virtual machine, we selected the service account, and below that there are the scope. We select the default scope. So this is the default scope. Now my use case is that from this virtual machine, I'm going to communicate with a Google storage bucket. That is not possible until unless I have a special scope assigned to this virtual machine. If I don't do communication, it's not possible. Cloud platform should be under the scope, so that within virtual machine, I can communicate to the Google Cloud Storage. So I need to add this cloud platform scope inside this virtual machine. To do that, first I need to stop the virtual machine. So I'm going to stop it. It will take a little bit of time to stop. Okay, so as you can see, this is what my virtual machine is stopped. So now I'm going to add that role. So for that, the command is gcloud compute instance set service account, followed by the instance name. This is the instance name. Scope I want to define. The scope which I want to define is cloud platform. Then my service account name. For service account name, I need to go back to IAM and then this is a service account. So this is my service account name. So I'm going to paste that here. And then zone, for the zone, I again need to go back to my virtual machine. Press Central 1 and enter. You will need to remember this command because all the comments I have already written in my blog post. So you can check the command from there. It looks like the scope has been updated. So now I'm going to restart the virtual machine again. Let it restart and then I'll come back when it's ready. Okay, seems like my virtual machine is ready. Now I'm going to execute the same command again, which is basically describing this virtual machine. Here's command. If I execute it again, no. Now let's see the service account. Service account is correct. And this is important. Under scope, I have cloud platform. So this scope is very important. This scope is needed in order to communicate from the virtual machine to any other Google Cloud services. Okay, so my virtual machine looks good. So now what I want to do, let me minimize that. I want to create a Google Cloud storage bucket. For that, I'm going to go here and click on bucket. Let's create a bucket. Let's give the name of the bucket is Sudipta underscore demo underscore bucket. Okay, I am not going to change anything. Keep everything as it is. And click on create. Just created a bucket. Now my intention is from the virtual machine, I want to communicate to this bucket. I want to log into this bucket or I have to go to this bucket and see what is there inside this bucket. So for that, let's copy the name Sudipta demo bucket. Perfect. So I'm going here, go to my virtual machine again. So this is my virtual machine. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to log into this virtual machine. I thought my virtual machine already started. And not. Yeah, so it started, right? Yeah. So what I'm going to do that is now I'm going to SSH to this virtual machine. So for that, click here and this is the command. Let's copy the command and come here. Let's clear the console and copy the command. So what it's doing is trying to log in inside this virtual machine. So it looks like it's doing that. It will take some time. Awesome. We are now inside this virtual machine. Let's do a clear. Okay. Now what I want to do, I want to say from this virtual machine, I want to communicate to my Google Cloud storage. Basically communication means I want to execute a command which will list down what is there inside that bucket. So for that, the command is gcloud ls gcloud storage ls gs followed by the bucket name. So this is the command. So let's execute the command. And I am getting an error. What is telling is that, let's understand the error message. This is my service account. What is telling, the service account does not have the privilege or permission to go to this storage and perform the LS, which is basically listing down what is there inside the bucket. That's why it's failing. So now I need to give that permission to the service account. The way to do that, you can come here, go here and click on IAM. So let's copy the service account email address. Let's click on grant access. This is the service account. And the storage of the permission that I want to give is basically cloud storage. So hold on a minute. I want to give them cloud storage and there should be a storage viewer permission. So I've given this particular role to my service account and click on save. Now with that, if I execute the same command again, let's clear the console and execute the same command again. There is no error. There is nothing inside that bucket. That's why there is no error. In case there is anything inside the bucket, it will show that. For example, let's go back to the bucket and experiment that. Let's go to the bucket. We are inside the bucket and let's upload something. Let's upload this JPEG file. So now inside my bucket, I have a JPEG file. Now if I execute the same command again here, it's telling that inside this bucket, I have this JPEG file. So what we understand is service account will communicate on my behalf from virtual machine to Google Cloud Storage. But to communicate that, service account should have the permission, should have the proper role to do that. initially it was failed because service account was not having the role to view what is inside the store, inside the bucket. The moment I gave that permission, the command executed successfully. Now, let's make it a little advanced. Let's say now I have a file inside my virtual machine. I want to copy that file to bucket. How can I do that? So for that, let's first create the file as helloworld.txt. So I have helloworld.txt inside my virtual machine. Now I want to copy that file. Command for that is gcloud storage, cp means copy. The file I want to copy is hello world, and I want to copy that inside my bucket. Same thing, I'll go back here. I already have my new test service account. Click on this pencil icon and add a new role, which will be, let's go to cloud storage. Cloud storage, and I want to give the option as storage object creator. Click on save. And let's come back here, clear the console, and execute the same function again. Copy was successful. Let's go back to my bucket. Yep, I have helloworld.txt. So what we have learned? So we have learned that service account is a special type of account inside Google Cloud, which is not linked to a human being. Rather, it linked to an application, and the service account is being used to authenticate and authorize that application so that it can communicate to other Google Cloud services. I hope the fundamentals of the service account is clear. Please go through the documentation. Make sure you clearly understand the service account, and if possible, have your own console, Google Cloud console, and experiment this. Whatever I've shown you, you can go through the process. And to understand when you are given proper role to the service account can communicate and perform action on your behalf. So this is a very important topic if you are new to Google Cloud or if you are going for a certification. I highly recommend that you go through that and make your understanding very clear. If you have any doubt, please let me know in the comment section of this video. And if you like this video, please hit the like icon, share with your friends, with your colleagues, and finally, please subscribe to my channel so that you came to know about all my upcoming videos, because in coming few days, I'll be publishing more content about Google Cloud. Please subscribe to my channel. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.